Scattered across the harsh, dry savannas of East Africa, a polka dot pattern of termite mounds provide green oases where wetter and higher nutrient soils have caused life to flourish. The termites found in these savannas are amazing social insects, living together in the millions and building mounds that can be up to 30 feet tall. Let's take a closer look. Here we can see the chambers the termites have dug to live in and raise their brood. And this is their fungal garden, where they grow a key partner, the fungus termitomyces. Termites eat dead wood, which is no easy task. To release the nutrients locked away in a log, the termites must contend with two hardy molecules, cellulose and lignin. These are the building blocks that make wood such a strong and tough material. Cellulose is a carbohydrate composed of a long chain of glucose molecules, and lignin is an organic polymer composed of cross-linked phenols. Breaking up these hefty polymers into chunks that can be turned into energy is too difficult even for our termites. That's where their fungal partner, Termitomyces, steps in. Termitomyces is a genus that contains more than 30 species of completely termite-dependent fungi, distributed across tropical Africa and Asia. These fungi are in the phylum Basidiomycota. Unlike many other basidiomycetes, they produce enzymes that can break down cellulose and lignin, which is particularly useful for our termites. The termites eat the dead wood and then go back to their mound, where they deposit fecal pellets of partially digested material onto the fungal gardens where they grow Termitomyces. The fungus releases enzymes to further break down the pellets, and then produces asexual spores called conidia. The termites eat the conidia, which contain carbohydrates, nitrogen, and even cellulases, enzymes that help the termites break down wood in their own stomachs. But that's not all there is to this story. Other fungi, such as this Ascomycete xylaria, would love to take advantage of the humid and nutrient-rich environment of the termites' fungal gardens. That's where the bacteria Bacillus subtilis comes in. These bacteria release chemicals to inhibit the growth of antagonistic fungi, so that Termitomyces can grow in peace. While the termites do provide a well-regulated, humid, and plentiful environment for the fungus to grow, they don't allow it to produce fruiting bodies, as that would take energy away from producing the termites' food. Therefore, these species must often wait until a colony has died or left before they can produce mushrooms. Many have edible fruiting bodies that are a delicious and nutritious food, consumed widely throughout Asia and Africa. One species, Termitomyces titanicus, is the largest known edible mushroom, with a cap that can reach a meter wide. Well, we hope you've enjoyed learning about this remarkable mutualism between termites and fungi as much as we enjoyed making this video. Thank you for watching.